Losing weight has become a very important thing for many of us, and especially as we get older, we're sometimes more aware of weight problems that have effect on our health. And I recently realised my weight had gone up quite a bit and decided I needed to do something about it. And what I discovered when I wanted to do something about it was that food made me happy. When I stopped eating all the trash that I was eating, I realized, first of all, how much trash I was eating when I actually stopped and just said, I'm going to have just breakfast, lunch, dinner, you know. I realized how much trash I was eating in between. And of course, if you're not burning it off, if you're not using the energy, then you're really storing all this fuel that later turns into fats, and it's not good for you. It's blocking up your arteries, you know, it's fat around your heart and your body, and it makes it difficult for you to do anything in life. Walking can be difficult, you know, or just doing the daily tasks that you want to do are difficult because of the excess weight. And of course, it's slowly killing you because it's not good for you. There are other things that can come as a result of it, like diabetes and, you know, heart conditions, all this kind of thing. But what dawned on me in doing this was that it is exactly the same for our spiritual walk. You can spend years without realizing it, putting rubbish into your body. Spiritually, you're taking in trash, whether it's from the television, from the internet, from books, from people around you, from whatever. You can be pouring all this trash into your body and it's not doing you any good. It's hurting your body. And the problem is, it's like a treasure chest that you have within you, and you've stored all this up inside of you. And the problem is that when you go to do anything, when you have any kind of a crisis or any kind of a problem in your life, we usually pull from this treasure chest within us to help us. And if you've poured nothing but trash into your spiritual digestive system, then you'll have nothing but trash to come back out. So we need to be feeding ourselves with the proper spiritual food. We need to be getting into God's word daily and really being on a diet of God's word and moving away from the trash that we've been pouring in, realizing that it's not doing us any good. In fact, it's slowly killing us. It causes depression. It causes anxiety. The Lord says in Philippians 4:8 that we should think on, you know, whatever things are positive and good and of good report, and all these things we're supposed to be thinking of. And the problem is that we feed ourselves with bad news, don't we? We go onto the internet or we look at the news and we take in all this bad information and we feed it into us. But we're supposed to be looking at positive things, and we're supposed to be feeding ourselves with God's word. And when we do feed ourselves with God's word, we are giving nutrition to our spirit. And when difficult times come, when we're struggling, when we're going through something, we have something then. We have that treasure there to pull from. And it's easier for us, just like when you lose the weight for your body, it's easier for us when we lose the trash that we have been pouring in and we replace it with the spiritual food of God's word. It's easier for us to be able to walk in our daily lives when things come along, when difficulties come along. We have something. We have strength. We have the power that we need. By leaning on God's word, by trusting in it, by relying on that and that alone. And that's something that I'm reminded in this. And I need to do the same for my body. Paul talks about it and he says that, you know, the exercise for the body is good, but we need to exercise the spirit too. And that's what I would like to encourage everyone to do, to, of course, look after your body. We need our body to function, to do things. But look after your spirit. Look after your spirit even more than you look after your body. You know, if you were hungry, you'd go and eat something. Your spirit is hungry. I guarantee you, your spirit is hungry. You need to be feeding your spirit so that you're strengthened, so that you're able to deal with the muck and the mire of this world. And it's getting worse. The world is getting worse, there's no doubt. I know we're in the end days. I understand that. We've been in the end days for the last 2,000 years at least. But we're seeing things speeding up now, and we can see the birth pangs that the Lord talks about in his word, that things are speeding up. The birth pangs are quicker and quicker and quicker, and we see the progress of the world, where it's just gone into madness. What was good is now bad, and what was bad is now good. And you know, the people are hateful and angry and bitter, and you know, all kinds of terrible things that the God's word said that they would be, that we would be. And so in order to deal with that, in order to live in that, and not only for us, but for our children and for our grandchildren, to be examples for them, because if we have it bad now, if this continues, if we don't, if the Lord doesn't come back as soon as we hope, in 20 or 30 or 40 or 50 years, what's it going to be like? What's it going to be like for our grandchildren? They need to have that spiritual strength as well. So we need to be examples for them. So to be an example for them, we need to take care of ourselves spiritually, to walk upright and to be into God's word, getting a good diet of God's word. So I'd like to encourage you today to do that, to look after your body, but to look after your spirit as well. And be blessed, everybody. Okay, thank you, bye.